have met twice before. And on both occasions, it's been the lady closest to us, Pi Hong Yang, who's won. They last met in October at the China Masters Super Series event, and they went to three games. Pi Hong Yang winning 21-19 in that. Their other meeting was about 4 years ago. Gu at that time was only 17 years of age. It was quite an easy win for Pi, but I think we've got another close encounter here.
The umpire is Wang Ping from China.
Toss to the side who's either going to serve first, or choose which end. So here we have the women's singles, Pi Hong Yang of France up against Gu Jian of Singapore. Here is Pi Hong Yang. World ranking 25, but that doesn't really tell the story. She was sixth or seventh in the world when she had a knee injury, so she's only coming back. This is her first tournament since December. Very experienced player, former world number four, and up against Gu Jian, who's had a really good 2011 so far, with that standout reaching the quarterfinals of the All England, where of course she lost in the quarter to Petya Neracheva. She was knocking on the door of becoming the first Singapore player to make the semi-finals. There you can see the last match they made. That was in October of 2010. Very close encounter before Pi had her injury, but she's won 2 out of 2 against their opponent. And there'll be belief in the French camp that maybe they can make it 2-all here, Morton.
Yeah, they, obviously they have to believe they can do it. I'm a little bit doubtful. It's so early to say, and obviously, you know, the commentator's curse, as we so often say, when you predict things. But I know for a fact that the French player, or the French team, rested Pi Hong Yang yesterday. And it was due to the fact of her injury and all that. So she's definitely not 100%. And it is her first tournament. And she will be very wary of, you know, any signs of whether the knee is holding up, or anything can go wrong. I think maybe doubts are creeping into the mind now and again.
Right. We just saw the exercises she was doing. She was stretching the knee there.
So. So, and from previous encounters, it's been really close, so I think it can be tough for Pi Hong Yang to win it. Well, it's a good test.
Under normal circumstances, you'd make a favourite, wouldn't you?
But absolutely.
Given the circumstances.
Yes, given the circumstances. This is something like this. Not getting to that one. Normally, she would get to that quite easily. But let's see how it goes. It can be very even. It can be a good match. We're looking forward to it.
That's a nice angle.
Service over.
That's very well played by Gu. Not an easy shot. And I think her tactics must be to keep Pi Hong Yang on the court for as long as possible. The longer the match is going to last, the better her chances are. Oh, well, that's a big miss.
Service over. 2-1.
Pi Hong Yang is such a lovely player to watch. She moves so well on the court. And for years and years we've seen her excellent footwork, how she's moving around, and makes it look so easy.
Those dreaded injuries get in the way, don't they?
3-2.
As you say, she has a fabulous pedigree, born in the Sichuan province. She's been playing for France since 2002. Also her opponent, Chinese born as well.
Service over. 3-all.
Right in the corner. I think it touched both lines. That was actually a very good shot.
Four.
The deception was great. She could have played any shot from that angle, and still she chose to play what she did, and she did it so sharp. I know some mistakes has come from the backhand corner of Wu so far, but I think if I was Pi Hongyang, I would start concentrating, playing much more to the forehand of the Singaporean. She seems to be very sharp from the backhand side. There, not a lot is happening. That's where the winners are set up. That's from that backhand corner.
It's a quality shot from Gu.
It is.
Strength, isn't it, on the backhand?
Yes. That's where small weaknesses in the forehand, deep forehand, not having the same options from that side, I would definitely opt to play there.
But
it's a difficult game for P. You can see already now that she's looking for answers. She's trying to find the easy answers if she can. If the rallies go on for too long and the angles are too steep like this, she's in deep trouble. So she's going for winners and answers the whole time, trying to shorten the rallies, trying to go for quick winners. And that's normally not her game, so obviously she's under pressure, trying to produce a game she's not used to play. I can see Luan Jin at the back, the coach. He's not happy. He thinks mistakes are coming too easily from Gu. And I agree. She can do better. She just have to keep it in, keep it working. And there's been too many simple mistakes.
Nine.
As I say, Pyongyang is just really searching for an easy answer, and she's getting them at the moment.
Yeah, you were saying that, you know, longer the rally goes on, the more these wants to close it out. At the moment, Gu's not keeping in the court long enough for her to worry about that.
Exactly. That's a good shot she's got there.
Service over. 10-0.
La seule chose, c'est quand elle pousse là-bas et que tu veux enlever la vitesse, garde un peu de main dans ton volant. Faut pas le faire trop mou parce que là sinon elle peut bouger pour presser sur le côté revers. Garde un peu de rythme. Faut pas que tu rentres dans les grands rallyes dégagement. Si tu dois faire dégagement parce que tu n'as pas autre chose à faire, pense à la faire bouger en gardant la vitesse parce que je déstabilise techniquement. Et sinon, tu vas mettre un petit peu de pression, tu vois.
No matter how hard you train, this match fitness is lacking. And the excitement of being back on court and all that is sapping energy. And she will be feeling the stress on the physical side as well, Pyongyang. So yes, she will try to find the easy solutions.
Service over. 11 on.
Luandian nodding there. He totally agrees with me. Keep it going, keep the pressure on. Mistakes will come. Just play it simple.
I'm sure exactly what you were saying, he was saying during that interval.
I think so too. The last three rallies have just shown, you know, just play the clears, play the lift, don't go for chances at the net. Unless you're really sure to play, just play it safe.
Service over. 12-13.
And we saw the opposite there, still going for it. She should just have lifted it, played it to the baseline. Don't go for that chance, just play it.
Praising her for keeping it in.
Yeah, and then the next two missed it.
Very good.
Keep it going, keep it going. Lift it. Yes. Play it back. Yes.
It's very well played by Pete.
Yes, it is. It's a good rally. Really nice rally. But you can see P is really breathing heavily here.
Yeah, she is.
She's, you know, we are just over the middle of the first game, and she is struggling physically. And the umpire says, very nice.
Yeah, I was going to say.
Very nice indeed.
Yeah, have a drink, have a little.
Yeah, take your time.
She's still catching her breath.
She is. You see, she is really breathing.
Understandably.
Yes, yes. No doubt. She's been out for a very long time and obviously trying to catch up, get back in. And it's tough.
Service over 14-15. Service over 16-14.
Doubles pairs will be watching this one very closely.
16-all.
I think it's paramount for Pi Hongyang to win this first set. It's crucial. It'll be a long, long, long way home if she's losing this first
fantastic
set.
Fantastic.
Yeah, this is a good game.
Oh, what a shame. I think, you know what, that rally's taken it a bit out of her, hasn't it?
It is. You can see hands on the side straight away. She's struggling physically. Nice return, that's bad luck.
18-16.
That's what I thought. When I say I think it's close, that's my way, if you're not sure of saying,
absolutely
not sure that was the right call.
I know exactly what you feel.
What an important point as well. Yeah. What difference that made. 19-16 to now.
Going out.
Oh, that one is out.
18.
She left that one.
Yeah, hoping.
19.
She had two on the baseline in a row and then hoping for the third one. Nice shot. Good try.
20, 10, 4, 18.
So game points for Gujian. To attacker here.
Again, punching into the forehand. A good option. Well played. That's the angle shot she doesn't like.
Be hanging in, but I'm afraid French hopes have just dwindled slightly there. Wu Xuan with some quality badminton in that final point. Wins the game 21-19. And as you mentioned already, it's now a long way back for Pi Hongyang.
It is.
Was
a runner-up in 2007 in that event.
Yeah, I think she has actually been all the way up to number two in the world at one stage. I think her highest ranking, she's been all the way up to two. She needs the break.
Well, I'm sure she'll be getting up those world rankings again soon. She gets back to the kind of fitness she would like. And, you know, for her, it's about getting fit and ready for the World Championships now, isn't it, really?
Yes, in August in London.
See the unforced errors there from Gu?
Exactly, 13. And still she's winning the game.
So cut those out.
That's what I mean. Yeah. You know, that's why Luan Jin at the back, he was like shaking his head. He said, come on, keep it in. And I can understand him. It's just very understandable.
So one more game required for Singapore here to claim Group 2 in the Sudamin Cup.
Points service fault and then service return fault.
Yeah, one shot played by Pete, 2 points won.
Yes. Good defense. Very well played.
3-1. Now I'd like to welcome the athletes and technical officials up onto the court number 2.
Oh, that's a nice save. Oh, well played by Pi Hongyang. Good, she was able to keep up the pressure of the net there. It's coming here, look at that one, very tight. Well played.
On court number two, we have the Wang Wai Kong and Zhou Haikao from Hong Kong, China, versus Andrew Lee and Justin Zhao from Canada.
3. Chance of getting back in this one. That's close.
Yeah, but she's got to remember that she's playing with the drift, Pyongyang. Don't have to push them that hard. But she moves so nicely, naturally. Underneath that, around the heads, and it looks so easy for her.
Service over.
That was excellent.
7-5.
Close for this out.
9-5.
It's a 4-point lead here for Pyongyang.
It's allowed for the coaches these days to talk to their players. As long as the rally is not going, then they are allowed to talk to the players and encourage them and come with advice as well. I'm impressed the way she has played the first half of the second game here. Very impressed. Shows great character. For Gujian to close the gap, and obviously for Pyongyang to get to the interval with the biggest lead possible.
She might not have a lead at all.
No.
10-6
up. 10-6 up.
Yeah.
Eight, 11, 10, interval.
That's well, two service faults.
Yeah, quite typical, really, yeah. That she should go to interval on that point, really.
Et remettre de l'attaque à un moment. Ok? T'as bien varié là, t'as utilisé les attaques. Force pas quand t'es autour de la tête là. Force pas le slice droit. Si tu veux varier, tu fais un morti lent, ça va passer. Ok, c'est toujours une bonne lecture, il y a une petite façon avec
Can she push this to a third game? I'm not sure whether physically she could stand it, but I'm sure she'll try.
She will try, but that's what I said in the first set, that it's very important that she's winning it. She did not win it, and even if she wins the second game here, I'm a bit nervous for her physical standards, condition for the third set. Good angle, well played.
Service over. 12-11.
Nice reverse shot there.
13-11.
As you say, she makes that look so easy.
So easy. Yeah, there was a change. Yeah, change in the serve here. It was the flick serve. Very clever. Good change. Good variation. She won't get that, no.
Service over. 12-14.
Can Rougerien get the job done for Singapore
13,
here?
14.
Finding her range really well, isn't she?
She is.
15-13.
She is playing remarkably well. I say hats off. It's really well done.
Must be a relief as well for her in some way. This is her first tournament back, and
it will give her some confidence.
Yeah.
That she's actually able to play this level. I think that would give her a lot of confidence.
We're going to watch Tina Baum tonight, and she's coming back from injury, and she was really pleased with her win the other night.
Yes.
It's given her real belief.
Yes, it means a lot. The net game for Gujun is not really working so well, and I would be hesitant to play it if I was her. Just play more to the baseline, be absolutely sure to when you play the net that your opponent is too far away, play it simple, don't go too tight. Lift. Excellent lift on the shot like that. Yang Yang is really pushing it.
She's breathing heavily right now, won't she?
She will be, I'm telling you.
Oh, she's getting there still.
Look at the hands.
15-17.
And I think that last shot there was purely because she didn't have the energy to.
No, she didn't know what to do. So okay, let's start again and then
hit it as high as I can.
Yeah, get it away. Nice clear.
Ooh.
The idea was good by Gu Jun.
18-16.
Good play.
Game points.
Setting out really well at the net there with the drop shot.
So, Pi Hongyan, after the joy of the men's doubles, France going to fight back here. It's one game all.
Second game won by France. 21-16.
Well, she's going to have to go the distance, Pi Hongyan, but credit to her there.
Tu mets beaucoup plus de vitesse sur les premiers coups dans le rallye, ça fait que tout de suite tu es en contrôle. Donc même si une ou deux fois tu vas te faire contrer, tu vas te faire une faute, tu restes là-dessus. Il faut vraiment que tu restes. Elle lit pas du tout ce que tu fais avec ta main. Tu fais une main, tu la fixes un peu, tac.
Once again, spirit.
Elle n'arrive pas à lire la trajectoire, donc elle est beaucoup plus
sous pression. Definitely.
Et toi, tu
as a really nice team.
Shouting for Pi Hongyan there.
Yeah, it's a bit of an irony. It's two Chinese-born players playing for Singapore and France.
Well, slightly less on the unforced errors for Gu in that second game, but.
But the little difference was that Pi Hongyan is winning more overhead shots than
Putin. Lafo play.
Thank you.
shot, Pi Hongyang, is well executed by Gu Zhong. But, you know, it's still quite easy to see that Pi Hongyang is not really back in full form.
Player who returned to the Singapore team in 2009. She actually took 16 months out. She went to pursue her studies. I think she'd pretty much given up on badminton, but she decided to make a go for it again. And obviously, it's been a pretty successful go, particularly at the start of this year. And that's another bit of success there.
Yeah, that was a lucky one. Pace is picking up.
Yeah, she's just up to game a little bit, hasn't she, Gu?
Yes, she has.
In the start
pace, pace is up, that's for sure.
And quality as well.
Yeah, from the Singaporean side, I think not so many mistakes as we saw in the second set. Oh, nice. Very nice.
Service over. 3-5.
That's the one again.
That's the one again. 3-4.
Out.
5-7.
That was well done by Pi Hongyang.
Service over. 8-5.
Just in the last 3-4 minutes, there's been 3 winners. Particularly on that one from Gu Zhong.
Nice. She's now putting her foot on the gas, so to speak. 9-5, the advantage. It's hard to know, isn't it, really? How much of it is it? He as well, unable to quite play at the speed that she was. Game occasion when they met in October at the China Masters Super Series event. Of course, that was pre-injury for Pi Hongyang. She won that one. Fair game this time might not be so lucky. Terrific all-round performance from the French. They were blown away in the mixed doubles, but since then these have been very close matches.
Yes, that's well left.
I think things that went out. I'm not sure. I thought that was in personally.
Yeah, it looks in. Just you can see the shuttles landing.
It was another high call, wasn't it? But I think it was just in. So Gu has an 11-7 advantage.
Yeah. See if you can keep the call.
Yeah. I think that's what it's all about.
对不对，我也不希望用又想推又想那个，你想怎样就怎样。Time
to breathe deeply, dig deep, and hope. The challenge going for France.
11-7, play.
Well, 16th was the best that France have managed before the Sidamin Cup.
So now they're playing 13-14th?
Yep.
Hoping, but she is against the drift.
Service over. 11,
in this
13.
Case, though, it's easier for her to keep them in. Pyongyang have to be wary of leaving everything on the baseline. And vice versa, have to watch out.
Service over.
Shots to the 14, baseline.
11.
Push back. Tape again, that's very tight. Good shots, bad luck.
Not by much, are they?
11.
But she is playing with the drift now. She's got to watch out a little bit.
Game of the women's singles, the deciding game, the decisive game as well. The way it's going could well be.
Nice, very nice, Pyongyang there.
She's fighting still, isn't she?
Yeah. And watch out for the cross, that's the one.
You saw it coming a mile away. You were quite good at this game, weren't you?
Watch out.
I'm sure Pyongyang knew it was coming too, but
yeah, you just have to get there. But it's, you know, when you know.